cans or 1 ton? These are the different 1 ton skins. And the 1 ton skins, they're two different kinds. Cantonese ones are the yellow ones that they wrap it differently. They just do it in a hand and they go scrunch it. And that's more like a Shanghai style. That's the one I make. It's white. And then you have to fold it in a certain way.
Okay, how do you choose a good watermelon?
Oh, you have to look at the... This is big. Oh, let's do the small one. You pound it. That's my father who taught me. My father taught me... See, this would be a good one.
But what's the sound you're
doing? The sound is like pounding, like fresh, like high tone versus... And then you have to look at the navel. Another good one. And there's some that are... This is not right enough. It's more higher tone. This is, we call it Cantonese Ngai Choy. It's so bitter, but it's really good. So your grandfather loved these. So much. When your grandma cooks it, she puts like loads of sugar in it to sweeten it. Here's a tofu. This is a tough one. They call it the firm. Firm is more for stir fry, you know, because it doesn't fall apart. So I like to use like the soft. For soup and for shabu, it's the soft kind. The sansei tofu is very smooth. But then one way to keep them firm is to put them in hot water. Soak it for like 10 minutes. And then you cut it, then it won't fall apart.
Here we go now.
Yeah. You know, I love chestnuts. So I will buy these all the time. Peeled chestnuts.
Bird testicles.
I don't see it that way.
Brian keeps these in his pocket.
You know what they use it for? When you drink all these Chinese medicine, because they're bitter. See, they give you a pack, a little thing of this, and they try to, then you take it. When I was little, not even little, you go to all these Chinese doctors, they give you this. Like one roll. This is a Japanese mayonnaise that we love so much. It's a product of Japan. It's the best mayonnaise. 79 cents. I was at Target, it was $2.90. Chun Bui Pei Pa. Pei Pa. It's like kumquat and loquat together. It's a medicine. It's for the cough. It calms your cough. When you have a cough, it's really good. My mom's favorite thing. But it comes in a really gooey, like a syrupy. So you put a spoonful, then you put it in your mouth, and then you don't drink anything and let it like this. And then like after two or three times, it's really, it calms your cough. It helps. It loosens your phlegm.
I bought one like that.
Hot kid flavored drink. What is the history with 1,000-year-old egg?
Well, in old days, they call it 1,000-year-old eggs because they buried them underground for days and months and years. So they call it 1,000-year-old eggs. It's a regular egg that they put underground and they turn black.
What do
you use for porridge, for breakfast, and then... And we put in soup sometimes. Oh, gosh. This is the Canton, they call it love, I don't know what that is, but this is an herb. In Chinese it says chicken bone grass, but it's actually it's an herbal grass, dry, and then they cook it, and they make it into a tea, and this is low sugar. But don't drink aloe every day, it's too cold for you, your body, it will make you cough.
Sounds like me.